martial artists compete in self-defense challenges?
What is the best martial art for self-defense?
Chat, can y'all fight, yes or no?
Is it karate?
Yo, what are these freaky ass emotes, yo?
Is it MMA? Is it Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu?
Hell yeah, yes.
Or perhaps...
karate?
Shaolin Kung Fu. Oh, we gathered Kung Fu. 6 martial arts practitioners
yes?
from
Midnight,
all across the globe.
Midnight, you can't fight. Stop it. Midnight, send me a video of you fighting. You can't fight.
Each representing different martial arts
you
styles.
You definitely had a little...
And we put them through various self-defense scenarios.
What the fuck?
And challenges.
Wait, this shit look lit. What the fuck?
You see who
Midnight, send
is
me a video you shaking
self-defense
ass.
Champion.
Yo, little man.
So,
welcome to the Ultimate Self-Defense Championship.
Wait, nah, this shit look tough. Ultimate Self-Defense Championship Season 2. Chapter 1, hide and go stab. The fuck? Arrival day, 10 a.m. Sydney, Australia.
It's 10 a.m. and the fighter house where the 6 martial artists will be living together for
hey,
the next 5 days
fight one
is
no
still
good
in.
On episode 2.
But
say
the first
that.
Contender was about to arrive.
Okay.
Welcome.
Bro, did she just call me a fucking monkey? Las Vegas. Gregory 32, UFC fighter. He's a UFC fighter.
Hey everyone, I'm Nathan Levy, UFC fighter in the lightweight division. I've been practicing martial arts since I was 15. Started out with Kung Fu, and I did some karate. Got to third degree black belt by the time I was 22. And then I decided
Shut
I'm
going to
make
the switch
to MMA,
left
to my
bro,
country,
I'm
my family, wow. my friends. Just burned the boats and become a UFC fighter with that dream I had.
Nathan was met by Jeff Phillips, one of the 2 hosts of the championship.
I'm Jeff Phillips from Western Combatives. I'm the co-host of this event. My role in this is to come up with ways to test people's skills.
Well, this is what we all came
okay.
here for. There's
so
the belt
with these,
for the winner.
And then, as Nathan continued
Listen,
to receive
Midnight,
a tour
you,
of
like,
Fighter
you
House, the next
Dora,
contestant
Edna
is about Mo, to arrive.
You're Mexican? Like, come on.
Hello, welcome.
Ranton.
Hey, shall I have something to tell you? So I know this guy.
Young Ye.
Oh, I know he's calm. I know he's calm. But he started talking to me again and being friendly.
You have been selected.
Not to treat him as a friend, but I still talk to him. But he has a failed talking stage and then 90%
I
sure she likes me. What do you think? And she's pretty nice, but I don't know what to do.
Wait, what the fuck are you talking about? Hey, Shaw, I have something to tell you. So you know this guy I used to be friends with. He unadded me on Snap and he ghosted me, but he started talking to me again and being friendly. But now I know, and I know not to treat him as a friend. And I'm still talk to him, but he has failed talking stage and I'm 90% sure she likes me. What do you think? And she's pretty nice, but I don't know what to do. Shit. Honestly, bro, like, stay to yourself, gang.
Hi, I'm Ranton. I have a YouTube channel still on Twitch.
He's a Shaolin warrior.
I graduated from high school. It's a long story, but then I went to Shaolin Temple, trained there for 3 years.
How you doing, man?
How you doing, bro?
Nathan.
Oh my god, I'm gonna have to fight you. Look at this. I'm a monk, okay?
I know.
Don't hurt me.
See your videos.
Look this way. So there's the belt.
Am I allowed to touch it?
You can touch it.
Don't get used to it, okay?
Lil did the 2 first contestants enter the fighter house knew, though, that the next day they will be teamed up to face the first challenge together.
Okay. Challenge day 1. So it's only 2 people right now?
You think the money is secretly a freak?
What's good, Nika Sean?
The first challenge was hide and go stab, in which 2 contestants at a time enter a warehouse, and where after 5 minutes they are then hunted by 5 attackers armed with knives. The contestants then need to escape the building and reach a car to get to safety. The goal of this challenge is to address a popular statement made by many that running away is the best form of self-defense. Yet as we already found out in season 1, running away may not always be as easy as one hopes, as you may be chased down or you may be accompanied by other people such as your children who don't have the option of running away, forcing you to either employ your hiding or fighting skills.
Nah,
unlike
like
in season 1 though, this time the contestants will be given tools to fight back. Each prop marked with martial arts and fitness equipment manufacturer's SMAI's logo can be used by the contestants as weapons. They will also have access to the Atomic Bear self-defense pen, which will play a big role in the future challenges too. And instead of running or hiding, our first two contestants decided to use these tools to fight back.
For me in my life, why would five people be running after me trying to stab me? I'm coming from the war in Israel. In my mind, the only reason five people would want to stab me is because I'm a Jew. These people is not somebody I'm gonna hide from.
Nathan and I, we had a plan. He was gonna lure people, and then once he starts shouting, I'm gonna jump out with the pen and stab people in the neck.
Damn!
Yet, if they succeeded, we will find out after the next two contestants are introduced.
Okay,
Jordan, welcome.
Jordan Persinger. Toronto.
Human Select is to showcase your martial arts skill at the Ultimate Self-Defense Championship.
Hi, I'm Jordan Persinger, also known as Jordan Teaches Jiu-Jitsu.
Oh, Jiu-Jitsu, Jiu-Jitsu. I've been doing
Jiu-Jitsu and training Muay Thai for 7 years. Amateur MMA champ. All my MMA wins are by submission, so I'm very much a grappler. My game plan going into this thing is to really represent Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Even though I can strike, I don't want to use strikes so much. I want to represent Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and do it as a pure Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt.
Okay. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, brother. I'm Nathan.
Anton, nice to meet you.
Around, this is what you've come for. I know you come here for this.
Yeah, I could be that. Chen, who do y'all think you could be in this thing?
And then Jordan was about to be introduced to his partner for the first challenge.
Okay. Thank you
so much, Craig?
Craig Hunter, he a boxer. He's a boxer for sure. Boxer for sure. Sydney? He a boxer for sure.
Jesus, that's next week.
Oh, no. Okay.
Although initially Season 2 of the Ultimate Self-Defense Championship was supposed to be joined by professional basketball player Kevin Achampong to test how much size and athleticism make a difference in self-defense, when Kevin broke his foot right before the championship, Craig Hunter, a regular person with a regular lifestyle and only occasional martial arts training...
So you just got a regular nigga. Okay.
Agreed to fill Kevin's place with only a week's notice in order to test and see how a regular person compares to professional martial artists in self-defense.
Yeah, g'day, I'm Craig. I'm just a regular Aussie bloke. You'll find 10 of me in most pubs. I'm a carpenter by trade. Drive a semi-trailer now. I have a little bit of dabbling in martial arts. I think I got 2 stripes in jiu-jitsu on a white belt.
Sporadic
training in combatives under Jeff Phillips.
Kev broke his foot, the basketball guy. Craig's taking his place. Jumping in last minute.
Yeah,
it's a big solid.
And whether Craig's plan to drink beer a day before the championship works out, we will find out in a moment.
Okay.
It was time for the second team to enter the warehouse, and their plan was very different from the first team.
I discussed with Jordan, do you want to get a strategy? And very respectfully, he said, oh, no, I want to kind of
Jordan,
do a solo.
And my strategy was just to hide for as long as possible when they're tired of looking for me, just make my getaway. I hid underneath the bleachers, which I kind of scoped it out while we were in there. This is going to be the perfect spot to hide, and I figured I could fit underneath there.
I didn't even have a hiding spot in mind, and I just saw this little balcony, and there was some scrub right there. Oh, I'm going to go lay in that.
Eventually, the 5 minutes ran out, and the knife attackers entered the building.
Underneath there for a while. I wanted them to like look really hard for me in there and then give up and then make my getaway. But while I was hiding, someone was coming from behind the bleachers, which I didn't know he could do. When I heard him coming, I'm like, oh shit, I gotta go now. And then there's someone right there.
Oh!
Got past him.
Oh, not he gone! Not he gone!
Hindsight, not wearing shoes was a big mistake.
Turns out, Jordan normally wears Crocs, and on his way to Sydney, he didn't bring any running shoes.
If my wife was here, she'd be making sure I had it. She helps me with everything, make sure I don't do stupid things like that.
He also had another takeaway from the experience.
I don't think that he could see me in hindsight because it was super dark. I should have just stayed there a little bit longer, but I didn't want to chance it.
But while Jordan was caught and stabbed halfway to the truck, Craig was still in the game.
I just crept in there and had a lay down, waited for the whistle, put my headgear on and tried to sneak out.
Now, he fast
was
as fuck,
making
though,
way out of the scrub, and I saw people moving, so I just stopped and crouched and waited for a bit. And then when they disappeared, I sort of gave them a minute to get away and then sort of snuck out around and down the stairs. I'm peeking, there's no one there.
Ready to go for a run, okay, look here.
I seen the door and I seen it clear, so I just ran for it. And then as I'm coming to the door, I see there's a guy there.
Damn! Nah, I ain't gonna lie to you.
Put him down and then kept running again.
Stop!
You're already out, dummy.
Even though Craig made it all the way to the car, turns out he was already fatally stabbed during his first encounter. And the encounter with the second attacker or reaching the car did not count anymore.
I just thought, maybe I'm doing okay.
And if by now you're wondering how many points Craig and Jordan received for their performances in the first challenge, that will become clear only after all the rest of the participants have taken their turns. As unlike in season one, where
Craig
each participant's performance was assessed individually, this time, in all of the seven challenges, the participants will be compared to each other. In other words, the person who will do the best compared to others will receive 6 points for the challenge, while the person who did the worst compared to the others will receive only a single point. This
so
means that we will find out how many points Craig and Jordan received for the first challenge only after the four other participants will have taken their turns. And having said that, it is time to find out how the first team did with their all-out attack plan.
I'm gonna draw them, I'm gonna be the bait, you go from behind it and attack them with the pin.
Yo!
I was like, I'm right here, motherfuckers, come get it. They all like look at each other like, what's going on? It's supposed to hide. I start whacking them.
Oh shit!
But I still understand this is a game. I'm still not gonna go super hard on your head, so I'm going kinda light. But then Anton, my bad, I didn't draw them far enough. He opens the door. And he's still right in front of him.
Come here! Come here.
I stabbed two people.
Then I'm like, Anton, come behind me. Just watch my back. And I'm hitting somebody. Boom. Sorry. Boom. Sorry.
Damn.
And then they just jumped us.
Nah, that's not a bad. A Discord fit competition? That would be fire. Damn! He did it! Nah, this is tough. Damn.
I was too much playing by the rules, too much being a nice, it's like sparring a guy. You don't want to punch them too hard. You throw a light kick to the head, you pull it, and then they grab your kick. 200% take you down, grab a rear naked choke and choke you out at 300%. Man, I pulled the kick. Seeing Jordan running to the car, falling, tearing his hands up, tearing his toes up. The dude is running for his life, fighting. Me, I was being nice, hitting them nicely with the stick on the head. The moment they started stabbing me, I was like, this guy didn't care if he got stabbed for real. He kept running and fighting, so I knew I had to step up my game. If I'm not cautious, I might not win this thing. And
time
no more Mr. Nice Guy.
No more Mr.
And
Nice Guy.
And now it is finally time to meet the last two participants.
They gotta have a boxer, right?
Hello, Jesse. This is how I imagine you would be.
The hell? Stockholm. Oh no, Nah, he's a demon. He's a fucking demon. Kung Fu, right? This Kung Fu? Nah, I know he a demon. Who he feeling like?
I'm Jesse from KarateByJesse.com, also known as the Karate Nerd. Every day from the moment I wake up to the moment I go to bed, all I do is karate. I practice, I teach, I learn, I travel around the world, write books and articles, do videos and teach seminars. And then I share my experiences with like-minded karate nerds who are interested in elevating the collective consciousness of karate worldwide.
Let the games begin!
Hey, how are you?
Hey.
Nice to meet you.
Like a real athlete.
Yeah, I like it.
So this is mine, and what are you guys gonna have?
And then it was time to meet the final participant.
The boxer,
who was arriving
right? the
following day, just before the first challenge. It was Jeff Chan, the champion of the first season.
The champ of the first season. New York! Oh, yeah!
Whoa. If you are ready to compete against the best for the title of the Ultimate Self-Defense Champion, I mean, I already have the belt, but I guess I'm returning to defend.
Oh, hell yeah.
That was like a Mortal Kombat message.
Hey guys, I'm Jeff Chan. I was the winner of Ultimate Self-Defense Championship Season 1. I've been training martial arts for 16 years.
Oh, never mind. He's a Muay Thai,
wrestling. I'm a former pro MMA fighter. I fought for one championship. Now I'm a full-time YouTuber.
Glad to be here for Season 2. Everyone's going to be a lot tougher this time.
Damn.
Jokes aside, the third and final team is going to experience their share of adrenaline in less than 2 hours.
Muay Thai and kicking and punching.
Here's the plan. Jeff has done this before, and luckily, we're in a team.
From my experience in Season 1, you can't hide, especially for 5 minutes. They will find you. This season, I decide, go big or go home.
So he has a strategy. He's gonna be the bait. He's gonna use his self-defense pen.
I'm gonna slow him down, because I'm gonna have a pen in front of me, and while I'm distracting him,
I'm gonna sneak up from the back and attack them while they're attacking him. We enter the facility, stand by the doors. Jeff is ready with his self-defense pen. I'm hiding on the other side of the door, and we hear them come.
With that said, instead of one person coming in, I think four of them came in at once.
He steps in front of them. So they're like, oh, this is gonna be easy. So as they enter, I sneak up behind them. And when I get close to this first dude, I just jump up on his back. And I start choking him.
The atomic pen actually slowed down the pace for me. I slowed him down and I threw a rear high kick.
Falls down to the ground, he taps out. I don't know what Jeff is doing. I think he's fighting somebody else.
He's still up! He got that shit off
him! So now I see another guy coming up with a knife. I attack him with both hands on his knife hand to control it. And I can sense that I'm stronger than him. So I know it's safe to let go of one hand, go under his elbow, and apply this arm lock. And Steven Seagal pops.
I can also walk him around like this.
Just kidding. I knew it from before. Drops the knife. I grab the knife. And now there's a third attack. We get into a knife fight.
Yo, these niggas got it, bro!
Yeah, drop. Drop it, Andre.
We got four guys dropped.
But at this point, unfortunately,
I think Jeff might slowly be bleeding out and dying.
Jeff didn't make it.
Damn.
I received a lot of that, but at least I got the closest to the getaway car.
Speaking of which, it is finally time to reveal the scores based on everyone's performance in comparison to each other. Starting with Nathan Levy, who incapacitated a single attacker using a broom, yet unfortunately died the earliest and made it the least furthest to the car, leaving him with only a single point. Next is Ranton, who made significant damage using the Atomic Bear self-defense pen and had an epic last stand, yet survived only slightly longer than Nathan, leaving him with 2 points. Jeff Chan displayed impressive fighting skills by tactically using the self-defense pen to keep an attacker at bay and using the opportunity to knock him out with a high kick, continuing to fight off multiple attackers, yet eventually bleeding out from the knife wound, leaving him with 3 points for surviving longer and causing more damage than
two
participants. Craig made it halfway to the truck,
He
ran all the way to it, he suffered deadly wounds before that, leaving him with 4 points still, as he got closer to the truck than any of the three other previous participants. Jordan made an epic escape and nearly made it to the truck, but his unfortunate fall cost him the win, leaving him with 5 points for being the second closest person to getting to the truck. And finally, after an epic face-off, choking a person out and winning a knife fight, Jesse Enkamp displayed the best performance in the first challenge by getting all the way to the truck and receiving 6 points.
Besides
the opportunity to win the title of the Ultimate Self-Defense Champion and the Champion's Belt, there is one more exciting opportunity and challenge that the participants have. As throughout the championship, in addition to the main score, a separate score is also being tracked for the best use of the Atomic Bear Self-Defense Pen, for the chance to win the Atomic Bear Trophy and a $2,000 monetary prize. Before the championship, all the participants were briefly introduced
to use
the pen by Atomic Bear's founder, while the pen itself was fitted with a special training tip in order not to injure any of the attackers.
That's only during the competition.
The winner of the self-defense championship is not necessarily the winner of the pen championship. But I get 2K if I win the pen championship.
Yes, you do.
So we go for the
pen. Each participant will be given two opportunities of their choice to use the pen during any of the challenges besides the finale.
So far, leaving
Branton and Jeff with only one more use left. And now it is time for the second challenge of the day, which even the participants didn't know what it's going to be.
I won't tell you too much about it until it's over. Anton can come first.
Oh. First?
Yeah, you're number one.
Good luck.
Come this way.
This is scary. This is so scary. What is going on?
Into that room. Here's the challenge. This is a floor plan. That's the bottom floor. That's the top floor.
No.
So what we require you to do is to write down...
While the participants did not get attacked, this challenge had an extremely important self-defense lesson to teach. As most self-defense schools focus on the physical side of things, a big part of self-defense is not only your ability to defend against an attacker, but it's also about the so-called soft self-defense skills, such as your ability to be aware of your environment, notice valuable escape routes, objects that can be used as improvised weapons, or the ability to notice potential threats early. Oftentimes, these soft skills may be even more valuable than the physical skills, as they can prevent you from getting into a dangerous situation altogether. That is why we asked each participant to walk through a corridor filled with various possible improvised weapons and threats, with them knowing that at the end of this route, they will be asked a series of questions to see how much they notice and to see which participant has the best environmental awareness. But before we get to see Ranton's score, let's start with the unluckiest participants first.
And take a seat. Need a seat.
Oh my God. That was a disaster. I expect to defend myself. I'm walking as fast as possible. I want to rush an attacker if they appear, so I'm just speeding through the whole thing. I didn't see anything, but it turns out maybe that is actually a very good exercise because self-defense is also about situational awareness. I learned my lesson.
I should have known better, but Jeff Phillips said, maybe you might need to grapple. And I just stayed focused on the grappling.
So I wanted them to think that they were fighting because it's easy to tell prior to notice where things are. But if you're not told that and you're expecting to be jumped, that's closer to what self-defense would be like.
It was very surprising,
but it was a good one. But I was didn't remember anything.
I think that I was going too fast. I wasn't quite aware enough, which is a problem I have in general. I have ADHD, so it's hard to focus on these other things when I'm just so focused on what I'm doing, which is don't get stabbed, don't get attacked. And it could have been way more aware.
Meanwhile, Branton had a different solution in mind.
I'm an incredibly forgetful person when it comes to visual things. I could talk to somebody for 2 hours, and a minute after I turn around and someone would ask me what color is their shirt, I don't know. Wait, my score for this is already fixed because if it's not, I'm not gonna reveal something right now. Can the score for that still change?
You're safe.
Because there are some things that I just made up. I just put a cross in a random room and I said stick. Don't change my score. I'm not the only one who made stuff up. I think all of us made some stuff up. I didn't fuck up completely. I didn't notice two guys. I noticed the broom. And it wasn't horrible.
Since creative solutions are also a part of self-defense, Ranton got to keep his score. But it were the final two participants who showed how this challenge should be done.
So we're basically walking through this part.
I think I was looking for weapons or threats. That was it.
I'll get you to put those three things back.
Did the best I could do.
After picking up every single possible improvised weapon along the way, Craig didn't have an issue identifying where they were and received 5 points.
Damn.
While Nathan used a similar strategy.
He's picking up things. He's walking around with knives in his pockets and stuff that he found, and he was on it.
Nathan remembered his environment even better than Craig. scoring him the highest score for this challenge.
Okay.
Dude, I don't remember anything.
You didn't see knives on the ground.
No, I was not observant.
I think that might be one of the most practical exercises you could do when it comes to self-defense, with situational awareness.
Damn, that's tough. That's tough as fuck.
The day has passed, and although there were 5 more challenges ahead of the contenders, before the next one on the following day, they were given some cutscene sleeping supplements for a good night's sleep, and then headed back to the fighter house to recover.
Okay. People have to understand, I didn't come into this competition as an underdog. I came into it as the under cockroach, bro. I came into it as a nothing burger, man. And then after the first day, I felt hopeful.
I want to win so bad, so like, it's just stressful for me. That's just who I am. You know, it's my mentality. When I saw Jesse come out,
make it
further
than
me, I was like, God damn it.
It became all of a sudden much more dangerous for me in the competition.
Jackie Chan
very serious about winning. This dude is here to beat my ass, and I'm gonna have to fight back and kick his first.
Then, after watching a movie and some fighter talk,
sparring Muay Thai champ blocked the kick, broke his forearm, just sat there. I was like, aren't you gonna go to the hospital, man? He's like, no, I can't afford it.
That's ridiculous.
They were ready to call it a day to recover before what was waiting for them next.
I think I did good in the awareness challenge. I won at the building. They kept fighting. And me playing by the rules, when I got like stabbed, I was like, oh, okay, you guys got me. I should have been like them and just keep fighting. Oh, you stabbed me? Ah, it's just a scratch. Boom, boom, boom. So I'm changing mindset now, and I'm coming to kill.
Yeah.
And no more nice, no more playing by the rules.
Just like, don't stop, just keep going.
I'm gonna keep going no matter what, yeah.
Okay.
The contenders were ready to go back to the facility where the fur challenge was awaiting them. Yet all they knew of it was that it was called Scenarios. And once they geared up with their custom-made and color-fitted ex-martial rash guards and SMEI's protective gear, they were ready to find out what the next challenge is, one by one.
What the fuck?
I have never in my life punched someone before.
Splints you have in your head like right before a fight. The moment hits the fan, adrenaline kicks in, you feel like you're in a bar fighting for your life.
We both 100%
one before.
Splints you have in your head like right before a fight.
Look at that
the moment
kick he
hits
did.
The fan, adrenaline kicks in, you feel like you're in a bar fighting for your life.
We both 100% believe that we're gonna be the winners, and only one person can.
And man, we got some challengers.
Okay. It's about to go down.
There's no answer. There's no right answer. You just do your best.
Yo, I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, we're watching that tomorrow. We watch episode 2 tomorrow. God, we watch episode 2 tomorrow.
Baby, just pick up the me. I just been locked by my chain. I just want hair or ring.